liver transplant is considered when a patient has end-stage liver disease or cirrhosis. Cirrhosis in the United States is most commonly caused by hepatitis C virus infection or alcohol use, but there are other conditions that can also cause cirrhosis. Autoimmune conditions like primary sclerosing cholangitis or primary biliary cirrhosis. There are even conditions that affect little kids like biliary atresia that can cause the need for a liver transplant. Unfortunately, when a patient becomes sick with a bad liver, there aren't great medical options, there aren't great medicines, and there certainly is no dialysis for the liver. So liver transplant becomes the only and best option. In terms of liver transplant, there are basically two options. The first is to get a liver transplant from a person who has passed away and decided to donate their organs. That's a whole liver from a deceased donor. The other option is to get half of a liver, a partial liver transplant, from a living donor. We know that a living donor partial transplant has excellent results, equal to that for a whole graft. The advantage would be that you don't have to wait for your liver transplant if you have a living donor. There are 7,000 Americans on the liver transplant wait list now, and the wait can be years, and that can be very difficult for sick patients. If you're lucky enough to have an appropriate living donor, you don't have to wait on the list. The most exciting development over the last couple of years in liver transplant is the arrival of powerful new anti-hep C meds. Hepatitis C used to be a very difficult disease to treat. The medicines weren't very good and they were pretty toxic. Maybe 2 years ago, we have discovered new antivirals. They are pills that are taken once a day for 12 weeks. They cure hepatitis C 98% of the time and they're very well tolerated. This has entirely changed the game for liver transplantation for hepatitis C. Now, many patients have had hepatitis C, often for 20 years without knowing it. So clearing the virus, while it's wonderful good news, may not prevent their need for a liver transplant. But if they get a liver transplant and take these meds, hepatitis C will not come back after a liver transplant. And that's a huge improvement in terms of how the liver will work and how long it will last. The biggest risk is not getting your liver transplant. We know that it is incredibly difficult for patients on the wait list. We know with mathematical certainty that if they need a liver transplant and they don't get one, they will die waiting. Liver transplant itself certainly has its own risks, but for example, the 1 year survival after liver transplant is over 90%. So if you get a liver transplant, the odds are very much in your favor that a year later and far beyond, you'll be alive and well. Specifically, we always worry about infection after a liver transplant because you have to take meds so that you don't reject your new liver. Those cause immunosuppression. We worry about bleeding during a liver transplant, but for the most part, complications are very well handled, and long-term success is the rule after liver transplant. Patients with liver disease are very complex and they benefit from a team approach. They don't need just a surgeon, they need an entire team. A team with a hepatologist, a dietitian, pharmacist, a social worker, a psychologist. We know that when patients have an entire team, results are better. Our goal is not just to perform a liver transplant, it's to restore a sick patient to their normal state of health and well-being. To make sure that the patient really thrives, we know that we do best with a multidisciplinary approach.